The Amman School of Excellence in Lebanon provides education to underprivileged Lebanese, Syrian, and Palestinian refugee children. Amman means safety, and this school will secure their futures by breaking the cycle of poverty faced by refugees around the world and providing a chance for a better future. For 16,000 rand, you can make dreams come true. Africa Muslims Agency, empowering, educating, inspiring.
أم حسبت أن أصحاب الكهف والرقيم كانوا من آياتنا عجبا إذ أوى الفتية إلى الكهف فقالوا ربنا آتنا من لدنك رحمة ربنا آتنا من لدنك رحمة وهيئ لنا من أمرنا رشدا فضربنا على آذانهم في الكهف سنين عددا ثم بعثناهم لنعلم أي الحسبين أحصى لما لبثوا أمدا نحن نقص عليك نبأهم بالحق إنهم فتية آمنوا بربهم وزدناهم هدى وربطنا على قلوبهم إذ قاموا فقالوا ربنا رب السماوات والأرض إذ قاموا فقالوا ربنا رب السماوات والأرض لن ندعو من دونه إلها لقد قلنا إذا شططا هؤلاء قومنا اتخذوا من دونه آلهة لولا يأتون عليهم بسلطان بين فمن أظلم ممن افترى على الله كذبا وإذ اعتزلتموهم وما يعبدون إلا الله فأووا إلى الكهف ينشر لكم ربكم من رحمته ويهيئ لكم من أمركم مرفقا وترى الشمس إذا طلعت تزاور عن كهفهم ذات اليمين وإذا غربت تقرضهم ذات الشمال وهم في فجوة منه ذلك من آيات الله من يهد الله فهو المهتدي ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا وتحسبهم أيقاظا وهم رقود ونقلبهم ذات اليمين وذات الشمال وكلبهم باسط ذراعيه بالوصيد لو اطلعت عليهم لوليت منهم فرارا ولملئت منهم رعبا وكذلك بعثناهم ليتساءلوا بينهم قال قائل منهم كم لبثتم قالوا لبثنا يوما أو بعض يوم قالوا ربكم أعلم بما لبثتم فبعثوا أحدكم بورقكم هذه إلى المدينة فلينظر أيها أزكى طعاما فليأتكم برزق منه وليتلطف ولا يشعرن بكم أحدا إنهم إن يظهروا عليكم يرجموكم أو يعيدوكم في ملتهم ولن تفلحوا إذا أبدا وكذلك أعثرنا عليهم ليعلموا أن وعد الله حق وأن الساعة لا ريب فيها إذ يتنازعون بينهم أمرهم فقالوا ابنوا عليهم بنيانا ربهم أعلم بهم قال الذين غلبوا على أمرهم لنتخذن عليهم مسجدا سيقولون ثلاثة رابعهم كلبهم ويقولون خمسة سادسهم كلبهم رجما بالغيب ويقولون سبعة وثامنهم كلبهم قل ربي أعلم بعدتهم ما يعلمهم إلا قليل فلا تمار فيهم إلا مراء ظاهرا ولا تستفت فيهم منهم أحدا ولا تقولن لشيء إني فاعل ذلك غدا إلا أن يشاء الله واذكر ربك إذا نسيت وقل عسى أن يهديني ربي لأقرب من هذا رشدا ولبثوا في كهفهم 300 سنين وازدادوا 9 قل الله أعلم بما لبثوا له غيب السماوات والأرض أبصر به وأسمع ما لهم من دونه من ولي ولا يشرك في حكمه أحدا واتل ما أوحي إليك من كتاب ربك لا مبدل لكلماتي ولن تجد من دوني ملتحدا واصبر نفسك مع الذين يدعون ربهم بالغداة والعشي يريدون وجهه ولا تعد عيناك عنهم تريد زينة الحياة الدنيا ولا تطع من أغفلنا قلبه عن ذكرنا واتبع هواه وكان أمره فرطا وقل الحق من ربكم فمن شاء فليؤمن ومن شاء فليكفر إنا أعتدنا للظالمين نارا أحاط بهم سرادقها وإن يستغيثوا يغاثوا بماء كالمهل يشوي الوجوه بئس الشراب وساءت مرتفقا إن الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات إنا لا نضيع أجر من أحسن عملا أولئك لهم جنات عدن تجري من تحتهم الأنهار يحلون فيها من أساور من ذهب ويلبسون ثيابا خضرا من سندس وإستبرق متكئين فيها على الأرائك نعم الثواب وحسنت مرتفقا واضرب لهم مثلا الرجلين جعلنا لأحدهما جنتين من أعناب وحففناهما بنخل وجعلنا بينهما زرعا كلتا الجنتين آتت أكلها ولم تظلم منه شيئا وفجرنا خلالهما نهرا وكان له ثمر فقال لصاحبه وهو يحاوره أنا أكثر منك مالا وأعز نفرا ودخل جنته وهو ظالم لنفسه قال ما أظن أن تبيد هذه أبدا وما أظن الساعة قائمة ولئن رددت إلى ربي لأجدن خيرا منها منقلبا قال له صاحبه وهو يحاوره أكفرت بالذي خلقك من تراب ثم من نطفة ثم سواك رجلا لكن هو الله ربي ولا أشرك بربي أحدا ولولا إذ دخلت جنتك قلت ما شاء الله لا قوة إلا بالله إن ترني أنا أقل منك مالا وولدا فعسى ربي أن يؤتيني خيرا من جنتك ويرسل عليها حسبانا من السماء فتصبح صعيدا زلقا أو يصبح ماؤها غورا فلن تستطيع له طلبا وأحيط بثمره فأصبح يقلب كفيه على ما أنفق فيها وهي خاوية على عروشها ويقول يا ليتني لم أشرك بربي أحدا ولم تكن له فئة ينصرونه من دون الله وما كان منتصرا هنالك الولاية لله الحق وخير ثوابا وخير عقبا. صدق الله العظيم.
صدق الله مولانا العظيم. Verily Almighty Allah speaks the truth. Shukran Jazakallah Khair Hafiz Ali Pangakar for that beautiful rendition of the glorious Quran. May Almighty Allah accept and may Allah bless us all through the barakah of the glorious Quran. Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina wa Mawlana Muhammad wa ala ali Sayyidina wa Mawlana Muhammad wa ashabi wa barik wa sallim. Rabbi shrah li sadri wa yassir li amri واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي بحق حبيبنا وسيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. يقول الله تعالى في القرآن المجيد مخبرا وآمرا قولا كريما إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا ومولانا محمد وأصحاب وبارك وسلم. My dearly beloved elders, mothers and fathers, brothers and sisters and beautiful children, I greet you with the universal greetings of peace, love and mercy. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Alhamdulillah, we praise Almighty Allah, our beloved Creator, the only true sovereign of the skies and the earth. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wahdahu la sharika la. As a Muslim, I bear witness that there is none worthy of worship but Allah and Allah alone. And Allah has no partner whatsoever. Wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan abduhu wa rasuluh. And I bear witness as a Muslim that I believe in all the prophets. And I bear witness that Sayyidina Muhammad ibn Abdullah, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, is the absolute final of all divine emissaries and prophets from Allah. Alhamdulillah, thanks to Allah, glory be to Allah, and praise be to Allah for the beautiful bounty of life that Allah has given us. Life we have once only. And we need to live life to the fullest and to the best of our ability and our capacity. After that, it is death. And then we will be gone from this world forever. Currently, this world is gripped in a global pandemic of COVID-19. And everyone is concerned trying to protect ourselves. Those for vaccination and against vaccination, but looking for every means to protect ourselves from this dreaded virus of COVID-19, and rightfully so. We need to take every protection and every care. But let me tell you, in case our people did not take notice, there's another dreaded virus and pandemic that is rising at the moment throughout the world, and that is the pandemic of Islam abandonment. People abandoning Islam, turning their backs on Islam. For indeed, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us, he foretold about this time. He said, there will come a time upon my ummah when people, not by the hundreds, but probably by the thousands, will turn their back on the beautiful deen of Islam. Islam will become like a hot coal that you have in the palm of your hands. No one can hold an extremely hot piece of coal in the palm of your hand. You will immediately let go because of the burning sensation. So Islam, people is going to get rid of the deen of Islam, deserting Islam. The Nabi alayhi salam said that time will be When a person will wake up in the morning as a believer, and in the evening, a person will be a disbeliever. And we look at the sad situation, the global situation in the global ummah, the beautiful ummah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, one can see that it is already happening. Why? Why will this be? Because people, instead of adhering to the beautiful teachings of Islam, to the golden rules of Islam, adhering and sticking to the beauty of Islam and the unique characteristics that Islam offers you, people will turn their back and follow other cultures, other practices in order to please other people. But let me give you the news that Allah warns us in the Quran. 1400 years ago, Allah Almighty said, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم ولن ترضى عنك اليهود ولن نصارى حتى تتبع ملتهم. Allah said, O my beautiful servants, followers of Islam, know for sure that the combined forces of imperialism and of Zionism will never ever be happy with you until you follow their way of life and you follow their dictates. And here you can hear I use the words the combined forces of imperialism and Zionism. Because there's good Christians and good Jews. And we refer here to the people who claim to follow Christianity, but they don't follow the true teachings of Nabi Isa, the Holy Prophet Jesus Christ. And the true Jews, they are our brethren. We do not refer here to those Jews who belong to the political entity of Zionism, who use the good word of Jewish and Judaism, who use the Torah and it's twisting the interpretation to suit their whims and fancies. And that's why we say the combined forces of imperialism and Zionism will never ever be happy with us Muslims until we follow their dictates. And so you can see how the Muslim countries in the Middle East are dancing to the tune of Zionism, dancing to the pipe tunes of imperialism, by now stepping forward and forming ties of normalization with the apartheid state of Israel. Muslim countries, including Saudi Arabia, United Arab Emirates, and all those others, forming now normalization ties with Israel, betraying the cause of liberation of the Palestinian people, giving away Masjid al-Aqsa just like that, because they want to please their masters. Every Muslim bow down in sujood and ruku facing the Black House. But they are now facing and bowing down to the White House in America. This is the sad state of the decline, signs of decline of the Muslims throughout the globe. You can never ever have normalization with the current state of Israel, for Israel is an apartheid state. We South Africans, our forefathers, and many of our fathers sitting here, you know what apartheid did to us in South Africa, where you had no equal rights because your skin color wasn't right. How you were uprooted in District 6 in Claremont and everywhere. Thrown in the Cape Flats. Up till today we are struggling to find our feet. 10 times worse is what the Palestinian people are going through. Because the Israeli government at the moment continue to uproot families and communities of Palestinians who lived in occupied Palestine for all their lives. So how can they, the Arab states, who claim to be Muslim, who claim to be the leadership of Muslims throughout the world, definitely not my leadership, self-appointed leadership, yes, who are selling out the Palestinian struggle for liberation and throwing away Masjid al-Aqsa, which was our first Qibla. And it will always be part of us. Saudi Arabia turning their back on the true teachings of Islam by having massive rave parties within the Holy Lands. Even as far as Jeddah, opening cinemas, going through a process of total modernization. This is abandoning Islam. Abandoning the pristine teachings of Tawheed. All the idols that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam got rid of, they are bringing back slowly. False idols like Justin Bieber and many other idols and icons of the Western world, wearing earrings and weird hairstyles, drinking khamr, sleeping around with women, no morals whatsoever. These people are welcomed into the holy city, having rave concerts in the Holy Land, which was the cradle of Islam, the teachings of Quran, where Quran was revealed, where the beautiful Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam emanate from. And these rave parties are attended by thousands at one concert. They had 180,000 people en masse attending. And the Muslim youth are welcoming it. They call it so-called progressive. What can be so aggressive in immorality? What can be so progressive in promiscuity, in teachings that oppose the true teachings of Islam? And then they want to claim for themselves the title of Khadimul Haramain Ash-Sharifain, the servants and the custodians of the two holy masajid in Makkah and Medina. Allah is definitely not happy. And as long as we Muslims worldwide are keeping quiet, it is like we giving consent and we are happy with it. There are ulama in Saudi who are speaking about it. They are opposing the Saudi government. What is happening to those ulama? Some are executed immediately. Some are thrown in jail and they throw the keys away. You can't even open your mouth and speak the truth anymore. But the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam teaches us, قُلْ الْحَقِّ وَلَوْ كَانَ مُرَّ. Speak the truth at every occasion, even though it is bitter. وَلَوْ عَلَى نَفْسِكَ. And even if it is against yourself, speak and stand always for the truth. You can rather die for the truth than live with falsehood and be a slave enchained in the clutches of falsehood and batil. This is what is happening now. And this is what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam foretold, that people will abandon Islam near the end of time until the great fitna comes. The greatest of fitna that this world will ever experience will be the fitna of Dajjal, the fitna of the Antichrist. People will leave Islam by the thousands. There's nothing wrong with Islam, but Islam will be purged from the hypocrites and those who only claim to be Muslim. As a beautiful say in Urdu, Baad banan asan hai, lekin kaam karna mushkil hai. To say something is very easy, but to do it is another thing. Actions always speak louder than words. I can say the kalima shahada, but am I prepared to live the kalima shahada, to die for the kalima shahada, and to stand up and meet my Lord with that beautiful and precious kalimatu shahada? This world is nothing. This life is nothing. Soon we are going to leave this world. Very soon we are going to leave this world. Let the tyrants think that they are mighty. Let the tyrants think that they have power. We believe, la hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. There is no power and there is no strength except with Almighty Allah Azza wa Jal. In some of the Arabian states, I think Dubai, they've got built recently the biggest Hindu temple that you can find even in India, which is a Hindu state. Revering and kissing even the idols in the temples. Where have these Arabs gone? These Muslims throughout the world, have they gone crazy? Have they gone insane? Are they already giving in to Dajjal, the army of Dajjal, who is preparing the way for the great Dajjal to come? Because the Prophet said, before Dajjal is going to come, you will find 30 minor Dajjals who will prepare the way for Dajjal to come. So when Dajjal arrives, his army will be ready. The Muslims will be few in number, but Allah will not leave us in the lurch, because Allah will send back to this world Nabi Isa alayhi salam, Jesus Christ, who is still alive in heaven, where Allah keeps him alive. He is a sign of a major sign of Qiyamah, and he alone, Allah will give the power to destroy the Antichrist, to destroy the Dajjal. And this brings us to the current period that we are in, the festive season and the Christmas period. Awareness of Christmas is on such a humongous scale throughout the malls, the shopping malls in the Muslim countries. Here and there, if you walk in our malls, you'll hear maybe a Christian Christmas carol or hymn. But there in the Muslim countries, if you go now, they make a hullabaloo, a big cry of Christians, of Christmas, encouraging their people to celebrate Christmas. Where are we going? Allah asks us in the Quran, فَأَيْنَ تَذْهَبُونَ. Where do you think you are going? You can never run away from Qiyamah. Qiyamah is rapidly approaching you. So let us look what they are promoting in the shopping malls. They're promoting, first and foremost, Christmas trees, which many Muslims are now also doing. In some Muslim homes, you also have Christmas trees. But Muslims are doing it out of ignorance, because the majority of us do not study our deen. The majority of us do not know our deen. Our children are growing up westernized. Look at the way our youth are dressing themselves. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam warned us, there will come a time when you will find young men having haircuts, shaving right around their hair. Right around their head they will shave, but they will have hair on top of their heads. The Prophet prophesied about this. And please, I'm saying it out of love and care. I'm not condemning you or anyone sitting here or anyone who's listening. I'm saying it out of love. care and respect for you. The Prophet warned us about this. In fact, it is not even permissible for a Christian to have a Christmas tree in their house. Do you know that? I challenge you and I challenge every Christian. Open your Bible in the book of Jeremiah, where the prophet Jeremiah speaks of Christmas trees and decorations of Christmas trees, that it is of pagan origin. And he warns people, do not have these trees in your home. Do not decorate it, because it is some form of idol and it comes from pagan origin. If the Bible prohibits even Christians to have these Christmas trees in their homes, where do Muslims come in? It's absolutely forbidden for us to follow these cult practices, which have its origin in paganism and Satanism. In the malls, you will find this man with a gray beard, dressed in red. Everyone loves him. Ho, 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 Father Christmas. Do you know that the ancient Russians, you know the land of Russia? The ancient people who lived in Russia, they had this belief in a person called Father Christmas, Santa Claus. And their belief was that God is ruling the world, yes. But as time goes on, God Almighty is going to get old. And one day when God has become so old and he cannot rule the universe anymore, then Father Christmas will take over after God. وَنَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ لَا حَوْلَ وَلَا قُوَّةَ إِلَّا بِاللَّهِ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ وَحْدَهُ لَا شَرِيكَ لَهُ لَهُ الْمُلْكُ وَلَهُ الْحَمْدُ يُحْيِي وَيُمِيتُ وَهُوَ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٌ. I'm confirming my faith in the fact that Allah is one and He has no partner. He alone, Allah, is the one who gives life and who gives death. And He alone is one creator of the entire universe. And so, if these have all pagan practices and pagan origin, then we can well understand our situation and our position as Muslims. And I want you to understand the very fine line here, because I've been inundated for the entire week by people who ask, they've got Christian family, is it permissible for them to celebrate Christmas with their family? Now there's a fine line here, please. Islam orders us and teaches us to have good relationship with our Christian and our non-Muslim neighbors. And many of us, we are a community, many of us come from a Christian background. I personally still have Christian family. We need as Muslims to have good relationship with our non-Muslim family and our non-Muslim neighbors. Islam is universal in its appeal and its outreach. So yes, by all means, there's nothing wrong in wishing them well for the festive period and wishing them well for the new year. But as a Muslim, you cannot celebrate Christmas, because it goes against the very grain of your pure belief and your aqidah in the oneness of Allah. Because the origin of Christmas is supposed to be what is happening with Father Christmas, as I mentioned, and the Christmas trees and all. That has got nothing to do with the actual Christmas. Christmas was supposed to be a celebration and a commemoration of the Holy Prophet Jesus Christ, whom we reveredly call Nabi Isa alayhi salam. And Allah even honored the day of his birth in the Quran, as Allah say, وَسَلَامٌ عَلَيْهِ يَوْمَ وَسَلَامٌ عَلَيَّ يَوْمَ وُلِدْتُ وَيَوْمَ أَمُوتُ وَيَوْمَ أُبْعَثُ حَيَّ. Where Jesus Christ, Nabi Isa alayhi salam, said, peace is on me the day I was born, the day that I shall die, and the day that I will be raised up to life again. So we believe that the day of his birth is an auspicious day. But there is no agreement on which day Nabi Isa alayhi salam really was born. And that is why you find disagreements within the various denominations of Christianity itself. So yes, we believe in Nabi Isa alayhi salam. No Muslim can be a Muslim if you do not believe in Jesus. We believe in him as one of the mightiest messengers of Almighty God, Allah. We believe in his miraculous conception that Allah caused Sayyidina Maryam to become Hamil with Nabi Isa alayhi salam without the intervention of a human father. Allah said, kun fayakun, be, Allah merely wills a thing into being and it comes into being. He was born, he was conceived and he was born. And Allah gave him the power to do great miracles. So we believe in Jesus. We believe in Nabi Isa alayhi salam. But we do not share the belief that Jesus was God, or he was the Son of God, or that he was crucified. But we believe that he will come again as a major sign of Qiyamah. And that's why, in conclusion, I quote the ayah of the Quran where Allah says, Inna mathala Isa inda Allah ka mathali Adam khalaqahu min turab thumma qala lahu kun fayakun. Allah say, do you want to know who Jesus was? Shall I explain you who Jesus, the son of Mary, was? His likeness by Allah is like the likeness of Hazrat Adam, Father Adam. As Allah created Adam by saying, by willing him into being, kun fayakun, be, and Allah created him into being. Likewise was the creation of Nabi Isa. Nabi Adam came into being without a father and a mother. Nabi Isa alayhi salam came into being in the womb of Mother Mary without a father. This is of the great miracles that Allah teaches us, that Allah is not bound by any law whatsoever. And so, Jamaatul Muslimin, let us realize that we are in a festive season. We live in an ocean of Christianity. We need to have good relationship with people without compromising our principles and our cherished beliefs in Islam. May Almighty Allah bless us, and I ask you to please take care of yourselves. We are still in a pandemic of COVID-19. The infection rate is spiking at the moment. Many people and families that we know, close families, are landing up in hospital. They are sick. Please take care of yourselves. Avoid crowds. When you go out in public, wear your mask. Sanitize. Keep your physical distance. And as I always say, whether you believe, whatever you believe, that COVID-19 is divinely sent or man-made in a laboratory, but COVID-19 is real. I can remember last year this time, it was my last lecture I gave in this masjid. And then the masjid had to close nearly for a month or two. And then I myself landed up in hospital with COVID. Staying in hospital for nearly 2 weeks. I know what it is. Having turned around from death's door, I can tell you for sure that COVID-19 is no joke. Don't take it lightly. Look after yourself for the sake of your loved ones at home, for your elderly. Take care. Do not indulge in unnecessary intermingling. Stop giving these massive parties and massive wedding receptions. Wedding receptions are taking place 3-4 days later a year. So many people have got COVID now. Please, people, let us take care of ourselves. Allah loves us, but Allah help those who help themselves. And Allah will take care of us as long as we take the necessary precaution. And do not treat the masjid as a place where you will get covered. People are looking for excuses not to go to the masjid. The masjid will not give you covered. This is the house of Allah. As long as we take our necessary precaution, we wear our mask when we come in, we sanitize, you can see we're standing spaced out. And even after the Jummah, we will open every exit from every side that there must be no congestion. No congestion. And no neck to neck. That we keep our space and our distance for our own personal safety and the safety of those who's waiting for us at home. May Allah bless us. Please take care over this festive season, wherever you go. Please take care of yourself, take care of your children. And may Allah bless us, and may Allah guide us. Ameen, Ya Rabbal Alameen. Just a few announcements. We make dua for Mrs. Najmunisa Parker of Johnson Road. It was her janaza now in the week. May Almighty Allah grant her and all our deceased Jannatul Firdaus. Ameen, Ya Rabbal Alameen. We have been asked to make dua for a few people who are sick. Haji Mustafa Emily requests that we make dua Shifa for Haji Talib Hercules, who had a stroke, landed up in hospital, and unfortunately in the hospital he got covered also. May Allah grant him Shifa. Ameen. We also make dua for Haji Nadia Jacobs and her husband Ashraf Jacobs, who also are recovering from the virus. And then, of course, for the parents of Haji Faisal Royke, that is Haji Idarus, and his mother, Haji Jamila Royke, who also have the virus and the sickness. May Allah grant them and all our sick people at home and in hospital, Allah grant them all shifa and kamila. Ameen, Ya Rabbal Alameen. I wish to welcome all the visitors from various provinces and overseas who are here. Welcome to the mother city of Cape Town. I hope despite the trying times that we are in, you will still enjoy, inshallah, the lovely hospitality of the mother city of Cape Town. May you have a lovely and a protective time here in our mother city of Cape Town. I want to remind you that outside the masjid after Jummah, we have some beautiful acne on sale, and we always make sure that we give people quality, alhamdulillah. And the proceeds of that acne will go towards the madrasa which run here on a daily basis, inshallah. Then next Friday, after an absence of 2 years, we will have none other than Haji Sattar Parker, Hamare Janab, who will be our speaker, inshallah, on the major events of the year 2021. And last but definitely not least, alhamdulillah, we are very, very honored to have with us the very world-renowned Haji Dr. Imtiaz Suleiman, who has been nominated the South African Person of the Year for the excellent, good humanitarian relief work he and his team are doing, alhamdulillah. I know he's not a person who seeks recognition. In fact, he asks us that he don't want to speak. But I just feel that, you know, out of respect for the man, for the work that he's doing, and wallahi, personally, Dr. Imtiaz Suleiman, I have the highest regard and the highest respect for you and your dynamic team for the good work that you are doing throughout the world. Can I humbly request you and respectfully request you just say a very few words to the Jamaat, please?
Jazakallah, Maulana. I really didn't want to speak, and I told him that very specifically yesterday. But I can't say no to this masjid, who's been so good to me all these years. Sattar, thank you very much, you know, for arranging a short notice for me to come here to keep space for me, because I know the mosque follows the rules very strictly for COVID-19. I want to carry on from where the Maulana spoke. I missed the beginning of the talk. But what is said about respecting culture is part of Islamic teaching. We come from a mixed society. The Prophet ﷺ came as Rahmatul Lil Alameen. And the Prophet ﷺ stressed about building relations with everyone. And this award that I got recognized for by, I was not aware of it. I didn't know how it started, but eventually it was brought to my attention that South Africans voted. Now we need to analyze that Which South Africans voted? Was it Muslims only? Were they voting for somebody that's a non-Muslim? No. This vote came from across cultures, across religions, across people who don't have any faith to, who don't believe. They say we're atheists. But all of them were willing to vote for me. What do I symbolize? My teaching all the time is I stand for tariqa, for spirituality, for Islam, for service. So human beings, their souls aggregate towards goodness. It doesn't matter who you are, what you do, which religion you are. The country has proven that. That people aggregate towards goodness and people in their souls want to support goodness. And this is the beauty of Islam. Real Islam recognizes everyone. That's why the Sheikh told me, my son, I'm not asking you. I'm instructing you to form an organization. The name in Arabic will be Waqful Waqifin. Translated, it means gift of the givers. You will serve all people of all races, of all religions, all colors, all classes, all cultures, of any geographical location and of any political affiliation. But you will serve them unconditionally. You will expect nothing in return, not even a thank you. This is an instruction for you for the rest of your life. And whatever you do is done through you and not by you. Brothers and sisters, the Sheikh taught, the Prophet taught, Islam taught that we have an open heart towards all people. And when we do our work, we don't look at race, color, or religion. We go into an area, we respect other people's belief systems, whether they're Christian, whether they're Hindu, whether they're Muslim, whatever they may be. We don't go and be judgmental about anyone. Only Allah knows the circumstances of people and what they believe. So when you have an open heart and you wish a person well for Christmas, which is a very sentimental time for them, or when you wish them Diwali, or you wish them anything else, they appreciate that. They show that you are not closed-minded, you are respecting their culture, their way of life. You are not following that. And the best way to understand this is, the first hadith that we are taught, actions are but by intentions. That everything you do, Allah judges your intention. So your intention, is it to become a Christian on Christmas Day? Is it to become a Hindu on Diwali Day? Is it to become a Jew on their celebration? No. Your intention is to foster good relationships without following anybody else's culture. That's why the Prophet ﷺ taught us in Muharram, the Jews keep one fast, we keep two fasts. We keep the fast, yes, but we are different. In Christmas, we are different. We don't celebrate Christmas, but we recognize that other people celebrate Christmas. And when you do that, and only good works, if the whole country can follow a Muslim organization and support a Muslim organization, don't you think they can support our good works and build relationships and terrorism and negativity of Islam and Islamophobia can go away? What the message is, brothers and sisters, let's all of us do good unconditionally to any human being, be a Christian or Muslim or non-Muslim or whatever. We mustn't say Palestinians only, Syrians only, Iraq only, Afghanistan only, like other cultures don't exist in this country. Every human being, every mother, we go to the areas, you see the hunger of the poor children. You see the stress of the old people and the young people and the couples and everyone else. They have the same pain we have. They have the same hardship we have. They have the same anxiety we have. And when you bring ease to that hardship and difficulty, they will never forget you. They won't forget your religion. They won't forget that Muslims brought goodness. That's the teaching of the Prophet ﷺ. We made people into nations and tribes that they may understand each other. You know, and the best among you, not that it may cause conflict between each other. We brought you to understand each other, and the most honored on the side of Allah is He that is the most righteous of you. So brothers and sisters, Jazakallah, Imam, for this announcement. I salute the country. I say thank you to the country for recognizing us. But for me, it's a special message that as Muslims, in our work, we can be recognized by all cultures, all religions. And the best way to pay that back is we individually, as every Muslim, should go and do good. Not to Muslims only, but to everyone in difficulty. And the final message, in Lavender Hill, one of the masjids in Lavender Hill, the imams and the recipients of the masjid handed out food parcels that we gave for Christmas to Christian families using the community hall in Lavender Hill Masjid. Now that couldn't be a better example of building relationships. Jazakallah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.
Takbir. Allahu Akbar walillahilhamd. Shukran, jazakallah khair, and pay tramakasi, Dr. Imdia Sulaiman of the Gift of the Givers. May Almighty Allah bless you and your entire dynamic team. And I can tell you for sure that we are indeed proud to have you as one of our foremost ambassadors of Islam and the Muslim world. May Allah grant you and the Gift of the Givers all the success. Ameen, Ya Rabbal Alameen. Again, I want to remind the Jamaat that after the Jummah Salah, inshallah, all the exits will be open, that side there, that side, and on your left-hand side of the masjid, and at the all exits will be open, so use the exit that is closest to you, inshallah. And last but not least, inshallah, the Arabic khutbah and the Salah will be done by my son, Hafiz Muhammad Hashim Alexander. So you've heard the father, you'll hear the son, there's no Holy Ghost. Shukran.
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح الله أكبر
إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين وأذل الشرك والمشركين رب اختم لنا بالخير برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين والحمد لله رب العالمين.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح. الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله.
الحمد لله الحمد لله الذي خلق السماوات بغير عمد الذي خلق الخلق ولم ينس أحد الذي لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له الواحد الأحد الفرد الصمد. وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا ومولانا محمدا عبده ورسوله نبي ما تطلع الشمس على أعلم منه ولا أعبد صلى الله عليه وآله وأصحابه صلاة وسلاما دائمين متلازمين نفوز بهما يوم الجزاء ونسعد وسلم تسليما كثيرا. أما بعد فيا عباد الله اتقوا الله ولتنظر نفس ما قدمت لغد واتقوا الله إن الله خبير بما تعملون. ويا أيها الحاضرون نتكلم اليوم عن عيسى بن مريم عليهما الصلاة والسلام. وما أدراكم من عيسى عليه السلام؟ قال الله تعالى في القرآن المجيد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إذ قالت الملائكة يا مريم إن الله يبشرك بكلمة منه اسمه المسيح عيسى بن مريم وجيها في الدنيا والآخرة ومن المقربين. وقال تعالى إن مثل عيسى عند الله كمثل آدم خلقه من تراب ثم قال له كن فيكون. وقال تعالى يا أهل الكتاب لا تغلوا في دينكم ولا تقولوا على الله إلا الحق إنما المسيح عيسى بن مريم رسول الله وكلمته ألقاها إلى مريم وروح منه فآمنوا بالله ورسله ولا تقولوا ثلاثة انتهوا خيرا لكم إنما الله إله واحد سبحانه أن يكون له ولد له ما في السماوات وما في الأرض وكفى بالله وكيلا. صدق الله العظيم. أقول قولي هذا أستغفر الله أستغفر الله أستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم ولوالدي ولوالديكم ولسائر المسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات فاستغفروا إنه هو الغفور الرحيم.
اللهم صل وسلم وزد وتوالم وتفضل وبارك بجلالك وكمالك على زين عبادك وأشرف عبادك سيدنا ومولانا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وصحبه وسلم سلم ورضي الله تبارك وتعالى عن كل صحابة أجمعين.
الحمد لله الحمد لله حمدا كثيرا كما أمر والصلاة والسلام على سيد البشر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا ومولانا محمدا عبده ورسوله. قال الله تعالى في القرآن المجيد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم وما أرسلناك إلا رحمة للعالمين. وقال تعالى مخبرا وآمرا قولا كريما إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما صليت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم، وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما باركت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد. ورضى اللهم عن خلفاء الراشدين أمير المؤمنين سيدنا أبي بكر الصديق، وأمير المؤمنين سيدنا عمر بن الخطاب، وأمير المؤمنين سيدنا عثمان بن عفان، وأمير المؤمنين سيدنا علي بن أبي طالب رضي الله تعالى عنهم، وعن بقية الصحابة والقرابة والتابعين وتابع التابعين وتابعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين، اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين، اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين، وأذل الشرك والمشركين. اللهم اجعل هذا البلد آمنا مطمئنا وسائر بلاد المسلمين أجمعين، فاغفر لنا وارحمنا وعافنا واعف عنا واحفظنا يا الله من كل بلاء الدنيا وعذاب الآخرة. اللهم اغفر لنا ولوالدينا ولجميع المؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم والأموات برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم إنا نسألك العفو والعافية والمعافاة الدائمة في الدين والدنيا والآخرة. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. عباد الله رحمكم الله، إن الله يأمركم بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر، ولذكر الله تعالى أعلى وأولى وأعز وأجل وأتم وأهم وأعظم وأكبر، والله يعلم ما تصنعون. أقم الصلاة.
الله أكبر الله أكبر، أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله، أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله، حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح، قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة. الله أكبر الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله،
لا إله إلا الله، سيدنا محمد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. الله أكبر. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. آمين. ولا يتمنونه أبدا بما قدمت أيديهم، والله عليم بالظالمين. قل إن الموت الذي تفرون منه فإنه ملاقيكم، ثم تردون إلى عالم الغيب والشهادة فينبئكم بما كنتم تعملون. يا أيها الذين آمنوا إذا نودي للصلاة من يوم الجمعة فاسعوا إلى ذكر الله
فاسعوا إلى ذكر الله وذروا البيع ذلكم خير لكم إن كنتم تعلمون فإذا قضيت الصلاة فانتشروا في الأرض وابتغوا من فضل الله واذكروا الله كثيرا لعلكم تفلحون وإذا رأوا تجارة أو لهوا انفضوا إليها وتركوك قائما قل ما عند الله خير من اللهو ومن التجارة والله خير الرازقين الله سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين قد أفلح من تزكى وذكر اسم ربه فصلى بل تؤثرون الحياة الدنيا والآخرة خير وأبقى إن هذا لفي الصحف الأولى صحف إبراهيم وموسى الله سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر السلام عليكم ورحمة الله السلام عليكم ورحمة الله استغفر الله استغفر الله استغفر الله العظيم التواب الرحيم الذي لا إله إلا هو الحي القيوم ونتوب إليك ونسألك توبة ومغفرة إنه هو التواب الرحيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم اللهم أنت السلام منك السلام تباركت ربنا وتعاليت يا ذا الجلال والإكرام سمعنا وأطعنا غفرانك ربنا وإليك المصير ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم اللهم ربنا تقبل منا صلاتنا وصيامنا وقيامنا وركوعنا وسجودنا وتسبيحنا وجميع أعمالنا. اللهم ربنا تقبل منا القليل وسامحنا بالكثير ولا تؤاخذنا بالتقصير. ربنا ظلمنا أنفسنا وإن لم تغفر لنا وترحمنا لنكونن من الخاسرين. اللهم ربنا أتمم لنا نورنا واغفر لنا إنك على كل شيء قدير. اللهم ربنا آتنا من لدنك رحمة وهيئ لنا من أمرنا رشدا. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار وأدخلنا الجنة مع الأبرار. يا عزيز يا غفار يا رب العالمين. ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم وتب علينا واغفر لنا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم. اللهم اهدنا يا الله ووفقنا إلى الحق وإلى طريق مستقيم ببركة القرآن يا مولانا يا رب العالمين. سبحانك ربنا رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين.
The Amman School of Excellence in Lebanon provides education to underprivileged Lebanese, Syrian, and Palestinian refugee children. Amman means safety, and this school will secure their futures by breaking the cycle of poverty faced by refugees around the world and providing a chance for a better future. For 16,000 rand, you can make dreams come true. Africa Muslims Agency, empowering, educating, inspiring.